say sorry, 'cause I'm missing more than just your body.
Welcome back to my channel. So if you're new here, I'm Tash, as you can kind of tell by the name on this YouTube channel. If you are new, hit the subscribe button, and if you like this video, please leave it a thumbs up, and let's just get into it. So as you can tell from the title of this video, it is going to be everything that I've bought throughout the month of August, whether it's clothes, accessories, makeup, whatever. I'm going to show it to you all. So let's just go into it, and I will start with the clothes that I've bought. So first of all, I will start with Misguided. So I went to Misguided in Bluewater because it's the only place that's close to me that I can try them on instead of just ordering offline. So the first thing I got is the Bardo Tie Front bodysuit. I got it in white, so it's like this. It is a milkmaid like style top, either with the straps up or like around here, so it's more Bardo than straps. This was the last size 10 that they had, and I was very happy that it suited me and looked good on me. I was thinking it wouldn't. I don't know why. I feel like it's something that I'd only be able to wear out if I'm going for a meal or something. I couldn't go like clubbing in it because I think my tits would generally just fall out of it because it's not too big around the boob area. But I really like this, and this was £18, but they had 25% off in Misguided the day I went. The next Misguided item I bought is a dress, and it is called the Ditzy Floral Bardo Frill Skater Dress. Again, this was £18, so it's the same price as the bodysuit. So it does have sleeves attached, but I don't really like what it looks like with the sleeves, so I just tuck them into the dress and then I wear it as a bardo, or I may cut them off because I probably will never wear the sleeves. And then there is a tie around the waist to like switch it in, and then there's like a frill at the bottom, which I think is really, really flattering. This was bought for going on holiday because I was supposed to go to Greece in October, but I am no longer going, so I don't know whether to really keep it or send it back. I do really like this, so I might just keep it for like next summer and hope that it still fits me. The third item I picked up is just a baggy crop top, and I'm sorry mum and dad or anyone of my family that is watching this, I just found this t-shirt funny, and yeah, so it's got makeup on it because, you know, what tops of mine don't. So it's just a cropped white top, and then it says I'm a virgin, and then in brackets it says this is an old t-shirt. I just found it quite funny, I don't know. So yeah, sorry mum about this, but I just love it, and it's such a suitable like length crop for me because obviously with my big boobs, crop tops don't really fit that well. So for this to be that baggy and it still look good on me is really nice, and I like the back wing kind of sleeves, just makes it look really flattering on me, and I think I'll be getting a lot of wear out of this t-shirt. So this t-shirt was, I think, £12? Yeah, £12. I got it in size 8 because obviously it is oversized, and it's just called I'm Virgin Drop Shoulder Crop Top. Okay, next for clothing, we're going to go on to Pretty Little Thing. So I picked up 3 things from Pretty Little Thing. The first being chafing bands. They just look like this. So they're just like a bit of like spandex material with a sticky bit around the top. Here that it like sticks to your thigh. So in the summer when I was away on holiday, or even here in the UK, I would chafe between my legs because I do not have a thigh gap, and I feel like a lot of you have this issue, but it's not spoken about a lot. So I wanted to give these go, but as it's getting colder here, they may just have to be tested out next summer. If I do use them, I'll let you guys know how they work. They do stay up, like, because obviously a sticky bit. I did try them on. They don't fall down. So I can imagine them working because obviously it's quite silky and soft, so they'll easily glide together so your legs don't rub and that you don't end up with scars and bleeding if you chafe that much, because I know I do. And it's so painful, and I've tried every hack out there and none of them work. So I'm gonna give these a go properly. These were £8. They also do them in black. We can buy 2 for £10. The next item from Pretty Little Thing is the red Ultimate Jersey mini skirt in a size 10. I think this was £2 because it was on sale. So it is literally just a red thin material. So this basically I bought for my Halloween outfit because I think I'm gonna go over to Devil, but it's a bit big, so I don't know whether to send it back, but you know, it's £2, so I may as well keep it and try and make it work. The last thing that I got from Pretty Little Thing is a dress. So I've realised that dresses with buttons up the front are quite in at the moment, and kind of going into autumn, all the like neutral colours are coming back into style. So this is the dress. So it is a nude beige colour with like turtle shell. Obviously it's not real tortoise shell because it's from Pretty Little Thing. Buttons, and I think it has a really cute effect to it. On the top it has two bows. This is ginormous on me, so I don't know whether to send it back or my friend at uni, she does fashion, so she said she can attempt to change the seams on it to make it fit me a bit better. But because I also have big boobs, the fitting around here is really weird. So I can't have all the buttons up because it starts to gape, and if I have the buttons down too low, my tits will just fall out. So I'm going to see if I can get this work. If not, then I will send it back. Okay, next up, I'm going to move on to Primark. So I did buy two things from Primark, but one of the things is in the wash because I wore it as a pyjama top as soon as I bought it, and obviously pyjama tops get dirty quite quickly, so it's in the wash. But it is, again, a nude colour, because you can tell that I like that right now. It is this corded skirt with a belt around the top that is super cute. I really like the belt detail on it, and this was only £10, I think. So it's super affordable, and I think they do it in the size like normal, like 10, 12, 14, etc. So this is in a size 12. It's a bit small fitting, so I would size up if you are to get this. Obviously this can't be linked down below because Primark don't have an online shop. They'll literally have it in pretty much every single Primark store if you were to go out and get it. Next up is H&M, and I've wanted an oversized sweater for so long. So I bought a men's sweatshirt from H&M that was only £8, and I got it in a medium because male sizes are a bit bigger. So it is this light baby pink sweatshirt. It's so soft on the inside, and it's such a good size on me. I think obviously if you're any smaller than me, go for a small, because a medium is quite big on me. If you ever want a oversized sweatshirt, literally any colour they have for $8.99, go to H&M. Super good quality, and they're cheaper than women's ones. So go to the male section, pick one up. This bag of goodies. So it is a Victoria's Secret pink bag. There is underwear in here from Victoria's Secret pink, but everything else in this bag is not. I just chucked it in here so I knew where it was for the film. First, again, I'm gonna go in with Primark for accessories, and the first thing that I picked up are these clips. So these like pearl clips are super in at the moment. These were £3 and you get four clips. Obviously, like the gold ones, I am probably not going to use, but these I'm gonna try and make work. The next thing from Primark that I picked up are some neon yellow heels. So I actually bought these for my friend's birthday at Junkyard Golf Club because I already know that there's like a UV thing. So these are just strappy like sandals with a block heel. These were £10 and I got them in a size 6. Although I do usually get a size 5, but they literally didn't have any size 5s left, so I went with a size 6. These hurt my feet so much wearing them. I think they just need breaking in, or I need to get used to wearing heels again. Okay, before we move on to makeup and other bits, I'm going to show the last piece of clothing. So the last piece of clothing is a pair of red underwear. So this is from Victoria's Secret Pink. It's got the band at the top that just says pink on it. I don't know if it will pick up on camera. And then they're just lacy, and they were all £5 each, so I thought I'd just pick up a pair. Before I move on to makeup, I have a few more accessories. So I went to Bicester Village, which if you do not know, it is an outlet village up in Bicester near Oxford, and it has like literally every designer shop you could possibly want, like Prada, Gucci, Longchamp, Calvin Klein underwear, Timberlands. That's where I get my Timberlands from, because like £50. So yeah, I got a new bag to add to my Longchamp collection because I find their bags so suitable for like day-to-day wear. So I got the pink large pillage bag. I think that's what they're called. I also have a grey one in the same size, a navy one in the same size, and a little grey one. So if you haven't ever heard of Longchamp, don't know where you've been. Everyone has the navy or the black ones. And yeah, so I picked this up. It was £60 instead of, I think they're usually £80, so it's £20 savings, which can't really complain about since they're never on sale anywhere else. They do not sell the black or the navy or the red, I think, in Bicester, because they're the three most popular colours. But they do sell pretty much every other colour, and I think they're just such good bags, as I said. And if you want them for cheaper and you don't want the most popular colours, go to Bicester, pick them up. The other thing that I picked up from Bicester Village is this little purse. It's from Michael Kors, so it looks like, so it says Michael Kors there, and then on the back it has like a few card slots, a bigger like card slot there, and then there's a zip bit. So yeah, it can hold three cards. Obviously you can double it up so it holds six. Can put cards in there, and this was £49, so rather pricey, but it's originally 80, so good save, I think. And yeah, I just thought it was really cute. I have the Michael Kors big purse. This is my big everyday purse that literally has everything inside of it. So I thought it's just easier for like day to day, going out, fitting in my smaller bags. The last thing is an iPhone 7 Plus case. So this is from Skinny. Okay, so it's literally just this plain black, like rubbery case. It says Skinny Dip on bottom. So this was on sale for £7.50 and it used to be £15. On to makeup bits now. So I'm just gonna go through what's in the bag. So this is the Revolution Conceal and Hydrate new foundation in the shade F8. So I have the old Conceal and Define one, more matte looking one, in the same shade. So I knew this is the right shade. Ordered it online and used this once and I already love it. This was £9, so I think it's slightly more than the original. I also picked up the Conceal and Hydrate concealer. So this is in C5, so I went a shade lighter than the one that I have in Conceal and Define, and I can't wait to give this a go. Again, this is slightly more expensive than the original. Next up, I have got a Collection Glam Crystals Dazzling Gel Liner. So I have multiple of these. So I have a blue, a silver, and now I have the purple. These liners are just so good and so cheap for drugstore. They're so similar to the Urban Decay glitter liners that everyone hypes about. But these are only $4.99. So, you know, what's going to win? The cheaper one or the more expensive one? Okay, so the next product that I am going to talk about is a product that is so raved about on the Instagram and YouTube community. And it's so hyped up as well. It's £6. It is the e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer. So this is a dupe for the Tarte one. So as you can see, I have used it because there is a massive dent in there. But this you can pick up from Superdrug. So yeah, you can get a student discount on anything from Superdrug. If, what is this piece of hair doing? Get over there. Thank you. If you have a Superdrug card and you have like NUS or you have Unidays, whichever one, you can get a student discount at Superdrug. Okay, the next few things are all also from Superdrug. So first up, I have got the e.l.f. Brow Pencil. I have also then got the Barry M. That Swell Lip Plumper. So this is, I think, £5. Obviously, it's not going to be as good as some of the lip plumpers that are out there that are around like £20-25. And obviously not going to be as good as lip fillers. But lip fillers can go horribly wrong and I do not like needles. So next up is a NYX Professional Makeup Suede Matte Lip Liner in the shade Sandstorm. So it's just like a normal lip liner, and of course it is nude because what other lip colours do I really wear? The last thing that I picked up from Superdrug is the Barry M Holographic Eyeshadow Topper in the shade Stardust. If you've seen my previous video, it is what I used on my eyelids in that. And it is just a holographic purple that you just put on top of eyeshadow, basically. The next two items that I have are both from MAC. However, one of them I did not buy from MAC. So I bought the MAC lip liner in Ruby Woo. So I have the Ruby Woo lipstick. So I thought I'll get the matching liner. So this was £10 and I bought it from Bicester Village in the cosmetics store. So I just literally just saw it lying there and I was like, I want to get that. So I picked it up, put it in my basket, bought it, now I have it. And then I thought I'd also pick up a new lipstick to add to my collection, since I had £5 voucher for John Lewis and they do sell MAC in John Lewis. So this is in the shade Half and Half and it is a Amplified Cream lipstick. So it's not the matte ones, they're my favourite, but I thought I'd go out there and pick up another one. This is the shade that I picked up just to add to my collection because you can never have too many MAC lipsticks that to be honest all look the same. Okay, so that is everything that I have bought throughout August. So everything that I can link below will be linked below. So yeah, I really hope you liked this video. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up. If you're new, don't forget to subscribe, as I said at the beginning of the video. And I will see you next week with another video. Bye!